Hi all developers, today we will talk about TCBSD and virtualization. So one of Beckhoff's biggest strengths is that it's possible to run your PLC code locally on your desktop in a virtual machine. So this is perfect for many reasons. One reason is that it's basically possible to prototype locally on your machine, so you don't have to buy expensive hardware if you just want to do some quick tests. And for me, learning is one of the biggest joys in life, so being able to run virtually and locally on my desktop makes my learning process much easier. I've previously been writing about the virtualization and TwinCAT on my blog, alltwincat.com, but that was more from a perspective of running it in a Windows virtual machine. Now we will take the next step and look how to run TCBSD in a virtual machine. TCBSD is Beckhoff's derivative of FreeBSD, which is a Unix-like operating system. Unlike Linux, however, which you probably heard about, Linux is just a kernel, while FreeBSD is a full-blown operating system. So Beckhoff now offers this as an alternative for Windows, though it's just for a few PLCs, not all PLCs. But I still think it's great that they're starting to look into using a Unix-like operating system for their runtime. And unfortunately, the usage of TCBSD seems to be quite limited, so I can't find so much people actually using it. There is a little bit of documentation on the Beckhoff website, which is good, but I still think there's a little bit of information missing, particularly about this subject. So that's why I thought I'd make this video, to show you how you can install TCBSD as a virtual machine, and then we use this virtual machine to actually run some TwinCAT software on it. I want to start by mentioning that everything that I will show you is not supported by Beckhoff. As far as I know, there is no documentation whatsoever available on the Beckhoff website regarding how to run TCBSD in a virtual environment, so this is 100% unsupported. Everything you do here is at your own risk. With that mentioned, we can get started. There are a couple of things that you will need before we get started. First of all, you will need a USB memory stick, preferably with 8 GB or more storage on it. You will need a software called Etcher. It's a tool that you use to write this installation file that will download from Beckhoff into a USB stick. This software is completely free. The third thing you need is a hypervisor to run your virtual machine. In this example, I will use VMware Workstation Pro. This unfortunately costs a little bit of money, although there is a 30-day free trial that you can use. I tried to get it to work on VirtualBox, however, I never got it to work. I had several issues. I had like problems with the restarts. The machine just restarted. It didn't want to start. It crashed, and yeah, just a lot of problems. If you manage this to get to work on VirtualBox, then I would be really happy if you could write a comment or two in the comment field and explain how you managed to do it. And the fourth thing that you will need is a PC with a host operating system. So for this tutorial, I will use a laptop with Windows 10 Pro, and other operating systems might or might not work. For example, if you can try it with Mac, if you manage to get it to work with Mac, also please write a comment or two in the description below. Final thing is that you will need the TwinCAT XAE on your computer. So this is necessary because we will just write a simple application that we will run on this virtual machine. I will not show how you install Etcher or VMware Workstation Pro. This you can probably do yourself. However, I will provide links in the description below to this software. So we're gonna do this together as a 4-stage rocket. First, we will download TCBSD from the Beckhoff website. We will use Etcher to create a bootable USB stick with this downloaded file. The third thing we will do is to create a virtual machine in VMware Workstation Pro and install TCBSD from this USB stick. The fourth and final thing that we will do is to connect to this virtual machine using our development environment, write a tiny application, compile it, put it on the virtual machine and run it. To download TCBSD, you have to go to the Beckhoff website and go to this address. I will provide it in the description below of this video. You have to sign in, which is free. You just register for a free account. And you go here to Software and Tools, Downloads, download the zip file, start the download, and then you wait for it to download. Once the file is downloaded, you extract it So this is in Swedish. Unfortunately, my operating system is in Swedish, but you probably get the idea. You unzip the zip file, and you'll get a couple of files, which of the important one is this one. This holds the operating system and all the files. The next step is to start the software etcher. This is the software that we'll use to actually take this ISO file and write it to this to our USB memory stick. You select flash from file. You select the ISO file, which we just extracted from the zip file. As a target device, you select the USB stick. So just make sure to actually select the USB stick and not something else, like for example your hard drive, because if you select your hard drive, then you're gonna have a really bad day. So make sure to select the USB stick and click on flash. Then we'll just wait while the software is making a bootable USB stick from this ISO file. When it's finished the writing, it will start to validate. You can just skip it. And then flash is complete. So now you have a bootable USB stick that we will use to start the installation of the operating system TCBSD into our virtual machine. The next step is to start VMware Workstation. Make sure that it's started with administrator rights. That's very important. So when you start the application, just make sure it's started with administrator rights. Make sure to select File, New Virtual Machine, select Typical. Make sure to select I will install the operating system later. Make sure to select Guest Operating System Other, and then FreeBSD 64-bit. Then you would need a name for your virtual machine. Here, just come up with TwinCAT BSD. Just come up with a good name. And this doesn't matter. Select Finish. Now we have our virtual machine here. So the thing we need to do now is that we will have to do some settings for us in order to... We need to do some settings in order to use this virtual machine. So click on Edit Virtual Machine Settings after selecting it. Select this hard drive, remove it. Click Add. Select a new hard drive. Select SATA. Select Use a Physical Disk. So what we're gonna do now is that we're gonna create a hard drive that is connected to the USB stick, because we want the USB stick to... We need it to do the installation of this operating system. Next, we need to select where this USB stick is, and here it's not very obvious. Physical drive 0 or 1, that doesn't say much. For this, there's a trick. Just go to disk, write disk mgmt.msc, which will start the disk manager of Windows. This is in Swedish, but you will probably it will probably look similar in other languages as well. And here it's easy to see that the USB drive, which is 8 GB, is this guy, while the hard drive on this computer is this guy. So just then we know that this is number 1 and this is number 2. So this is the guy that we're going to use for the installation that has the TCBSD install files. So in this case, it means it's this guy. Select Use Entire Disk. Click Finish. Now we also need to add another hard drive. So now we need a second hard drive, because this is the hard drive where we're gonna actually install the operating system to. So select hard disk, select next, select SATA next, select create a new virtual disk. 20 GB is fine, and then just leave it like this. I think 20 GB is much more than necessary. And then select Finish. There's some other settings we need to do. First, we can allocate a little bit more memory. I think 256 MB is probably enough. I mean, Beckhoff are selling a PLC that's using TCBSD that has, I don't know, 32 MB or something memory, so it should work with 256 MB. But let's just increase it to 2 GB, because we have memory to spare here on this computer. The next thing we need to do is to select Options, and then go to Advanced, and make sure that firmware type here is UEFI. Okay, so this has to do with the booting of the USB stick. I'm not gonna go into details here. I could talk about this probably, but you would just get very bored about it. So just select UEFI, and I think that's everything. Now we can click OK. Now we have all the settings we need on this virtual machine, so we can power it on. Just select yes here. Stuff happening, and this looks good. So Beckhoff. Yeah, just wait. It's gonna do its magic. TCBSD. That's really fancy, right? So this is the installer for TCBSD. When I was running this the first time very recently, then I thought it was a little exciting. I mean, it is fun after all. Now we have come to this window, select TCBSD install. And now this is the 20 GB hard drive that we selected, that we created in the previous step when we configured this virtual machine. So make sure this guy is selected. Install TCBSD, select yes. Enter a password for the administrator account. And as well, we have to do what we usually do and just select a one. I would of course encourage you to use a better password, but just let's go with the classical one as password. And then it will start the installation. Installation of TCBSD complete. That sounds good, right? Select OK. Oops. And just shut down. The reason I select shut down is because now we don't need this USB stick anymore. So we don't need the hard drive with the USB stick. Now that we have installed TCBSD from the USB stick into our virtual machine, we don't need the hard drive with this USB stick. So the hard drive with the USB stick we can remove. So not the one with 20 gigabytes, but the other one. Remove it, select OK, and start the virtual machine again. It's a Beckhoff there, it was a little cool. Now I knew this was gonna happen because I've been struggling with this for a little bit too long time and trying to figure out why this happens. So now you don't have to do it because I will explain to you what you're supposed to do, so you don't have to waste the hours I had to spend to figure this out. Just press OK, select edit virtual machine settings, the hard drive, and check where the disk file for this hard drive is. So this is where the file where your the operating system is installed that the virtual machine is using. Go to the folder where this file is. So what you can do here, and delete this file that ends with nvram. So this is the folder with your virtual machine. Just delete this particular file. Delete it. Select OK. And now you can power it on again. So back off there. It's a little cool. Yeah. And the TCBSD logo, which I think is a little fancy. I think, good job, Beckhoff. Wait for it to start. And now it started. So it of course looks a little bit different than Windows, than what you're used to. For anyone that has been using any Unix derivative or Linux, this is not any big surprise. You log in with administrator and password, the password that you selected in this case, one. And now we have started. So this is a little interesting, because here you can actually see which TwinCAT build that's integrated into this version of the operating system. So it seems that Beckhoff are bundling it together with the whole operating system image, which is similar to what they have done with the Windows CE images that I've been using. And you got the AMSNet ID of the PLC and the version of this operating system. So now we're ready to use it, and this behaves just like any other shell that you're used to if you've been using Linux, so you can do all the stuff that you're used to, which is very convenient. I will not go too deep into this in this particular video, because I'm planning to do more videos about TCBSD. So here I will just make sure to, now I show you how to install it. Now we will also take the next step, which is actually running some TwinCAT 3 software on this virtual machine. To do that, we start our TwinCAT 3 development environment. In this case, I will just use the vanilla TCXAE shell. Select new TwinCAT project. Let's call it TCBSD test. Okay. This computer is insanely slow. Oh, finally. Add new item, just create a PLC project. While sitting and waiting here, I have actually decided to buy a new computer now, or build a new, because this computer drives me crazy. Next, we need to make sure to connect to our target. So we have an ADS connection, go to router, select add. Do a broadcast search, it should detect it. Just select all the adapters. It should detect the virtual machine. There's no firewall stuff going on. Ah, yeah, and there we are. We can actually even see it here. TCBSD as OS version. Perfect. Select add route. Password 1 or whatever password you selected. And now we have a connection to the TwinCAT PLC. To the TCBSD PLC. Okay, which means we have it here. So we select that as target, not local desktop, but this PLC, this virtual machine. Now let's just create a very simple program, a very simple counter. Just a counter that increments and activate the configuration. Some required runtime licenses missing, yes. We will not try, because this is a fresh virtual machine, so we need some trial licenses on it to be able to run the software. And restart in run mode, yes. Login, select yes, and run. And magic, the software is running on our TCBSD virtual machine. So I want to finish by saying that I will most likely come back to the topic of TCBSD in future episode of this channel. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so and press the like button if you like this video. And if you really, really like the content that I'm doing here, then please consider becoming either a YouTube member of this channel or a Patreon member. And if you have any thoughts or any ideas or anything that you want to share, then please write a comment or two. So until next time, see you.